Hi, I'm Angela with the Google Maps platform team. You may notice that our geocasts look a little different these days, but we're still working on making videos with helpful tips and useful announcements. Lately, I've been very interested in knowing when places around me are open. Did you know you can get opening hours and current open status through the Places API? I'll show you how to obtain opening hours and whether a business is currently open through our four main ways of calling the Places API: HTTP requests to the Web Services API, the Places library in the Maps JavaScript API, the Places SDK for Android, and the Places SDK for iOS. In an HTTP request to the Places API, request the opening underscore hours field to get this information. You can specify opening hours as a field in a Place Details request in any of our Places API or SDKs. This can be a standalone Place Details request or a request for a place that a user has chosen in a Place Autocomplete experience. If Google has information about opening hours and if the place is not marked closed, you'll see opening hours in the response. Opening hours can have three properties under it. Open underscore now indicates whether the place is currently open at the time the request was sent. Periods is an array of the 7 days of the week with open and closed times. Weekday underscore text is an array of 7 formatted strings for each day of the week. If a language parameter was specified in the request, the Places service will localize this text for that language. Are you using one of our client-side SDKs? Instead of the open underscore now property, the JavaScript, Android, and iOS SDKs have a method called isOpen that allows you to request whether a place is currently open or specify a specific time to check if the place will be open at that time according to the place's registered hours. To use isOpen, you will need to include two fields in your Place Details request: opening hours and UTC offset minutes. This is because when you call isOpen, you have the option of specifying a time other than right now to check for opening hours. For example, if you want to indicate whether the place will be open at 9 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, you would supply that time in Unix epoch time in milliseconds. The isOpen method needs the UTC offset minutes to translate that place's opening hours, which are written in the place's local time zone, into coordinated universal time so it can compare the opening hours with the Unix time you supplied as a parameter. isOpen can be called on objects that are returned from Place Details requests through these SDKs. First, I'll show you what this looks like in JavaScript, because we recently announced a change to Places fields related to opening hours in JavaScript. Here is a sample for requesting Place Details. Place Details are requested through the Places service method called getDetails. We specify the fields we want returned here in the request parameters. The callback function first checks if we got a successful response and also checks whether both opening hours and UTC offset minutes exist in the response. Remember, if we don't have opening hours information or offset minutes, they will be omitted from the response. If both are present, these lines demonstrate using isOpen with no parameters to check whether a place is currently open. These lines demonstrate passing a time into isOpen to check whether a place is expected to be open at a specific time based on the opening hours. Here's an example of doing the same through the Places SDK for Android. Set up a list of fields you want returned and pass that list to the Fetch Place Request builder. Then pass the request to the Places client Fetch Place method to request Place Details. Just like with JavaScript, if you don't pass a time to the isOpen method, it will return true if the current time falls within the place opening hours. If you do pass a number corresponding to Unix epoch time, the isOpen method calculates whether the specified time falls within the place's opening hours. Finally, let's take a look at how it looks with the Places SDK for iOS. Again, we set up the list of fields we want back. Then we use the Places client method called fetchPlaceFromPlaceID to request place details, passing in the fields list. The difference for iOS is that iOS provides two separate methods that you can call on the place object that gets returned. One method is called isOpen, which corresponds to whether the place is open at the time the request is made. To get the open status at a different time, you'll need to call a different method called isOpenAtDate and pass in a date parameter. Well, that's a lot to remember. Instead of trying to memorize how everything behaves, you can check the documentation linked in this video description for the most up-to-date information about how each of the endpoints and SDKs behaves with Places API. I'm working on another video to explain how to filter for places that are currently open when doing a place search. Please subscribe to get notified when that video gets published. Thanks for watching and happy coding!